Hello and welcome to Tech. I am Muhammad Adnan and in this video we are going to discuss about dynamic rank by user selection in Power BI. It's a real world case in Power BI. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notification. Now let's get started. This is the Power BI file. This I have the data from 2017 to 2019. Based on these dates, based on these 3 years almost, we have this ranking. Now, if the user want to have a look at the rank based on 2017 separate, 2018 separate, and 2019 separate, in that case, how it can be achieved. Now, if the user wants to change a year, say for example, if you have to look at the year 2017 alone, then it is utility bike, comfort bike, and then the fitness bike, 1, 2, 3. And if you change the selection to 2 years, utility, comfort, and fitness, and only for 2018, here we have comfort, mountain bike, and then the kids. So utility and fitness comes under 4th and 5th rank during 2018. So let's have a look at the DAX measure, what I've written here. I've made a video about the rank X DAX function. If you haven't seen that, just click on the link given on top of your screen, and this is the successor of it. So I have taken two measures. One is the sales sum. It is just the sum of sales value, and then the rank X function. Nothing special. I have just taken the rank X, all of the product, and comma sum of sales. So here I have taken the measure instead of a column. I have taken the measure here, and there is a relationship between this product and the sales table. This product ID is linked with the sales product column, and then in the table I have taken the value of the product name from the product table and the sales sum from the sales table and the rank X function. So there are three steps I have taken here to work this dynamic ranking. First is I have made a relationship between the sales and the product table. And then I have created a measure sum of sales and also one more measure for rank X. Inside the rank X, I used all product from the product table, comma, the sum X measure. By adopting these three steps and these two small DAX calculations, we can easily get the dynamic ranking based on the user selection. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button. And also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. But make sure you turn on the notification on your devices. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.